All right, folks, now we're ready to put the upper sheet on. And in order to get ready to do that, first thing we've got to do is staple along the top here so we can get rid of these screws that are holding everything up. Of course, I've already got all the nails in, you saw that, and it's holding itself just fine. So we'll go ahead and flatten this out, we'll staple it, and then we will attach our wood support, which is what we hang it by, to the top of the sheet, and we'll hang it up here, get it in position. We'll temporarily screw it in along the edge here where the seam is, and I'll go inside and I will scribe the lines for the inside of the trailer for the windows and the door. And this time I'll go ahead and photograph that process also from both the outside and the inside. And then we will remove the sheet, get it down here, get our windows and our door cut into it. We'll do a little stabilization of the door area because it's going to be losing a lot of metal there, and it'll be a very weak point in the metal, so we'll have to stabilize that as well. And then we will put our seal tape here, which is actually nothing more than glazing tape for glass, and then we'll put it back up permanently, and that'll be the top sheet on the street side. I'm sorry, it'll be the top sheet on the curb side. So, let's get at it. Alright, I've got it down about 80 pounds. These are half inch staples, we don't need any more than that. Thank you, Steve. Okay, as you can see, we snapped a line. I forgot to turn the camera on, but we just snapped another line. You see plenty of that. And that's the line that we're gonna have our seam at. It's 2.5 inches below the window, just like the other side. And that gives us plenty of room for our seam tape there. Just getting our ropes ready with our hooks here. Well, these are, what do you call these? Little spring-loaded carabiner things. That's all they are. And now we'll go ahead and get the metal up there. This is going to be a lot of fun. Not the easiest thing to play with. I think the way to do this is to get the whole coil sitting on top of the table and then slide it over. Can't afford to kink it, okay? And if it starts to fall one way or the other and you're holding onto it, it can kink and create a bend.
So you can set the bottom edge on the table?
Yeah. Okay. I think, yeah. Yeah, the only thing is, you're going to want to walk it around over there. We're going to actually spin it and set it so that the break between the two ends is like here somewhere, okay? Because that end's going to go down there.
Okay.
Okay, so. Put it down. When you hold it like that with just two fingers, you're kinking it. You're putting a bend in it. You want to use as much of your hand as possible and don't squeeze any more than you have to. Okay? I know. You're not very tall either.
Well, that's a shock.
Ah.
I didn't know.
You walk around the end of the table. I can't see you.
Okay.
You're on the other side of the table.
Okay.
Okay. See what I mean?
Yeah.
All right, that's what we're going for. All right, lift up the bottom of that. There you go. Yeah. Set it down. start laying it down.
All right, we got it. Jesus.
It's only because it's so short.
That was easy.
I'm a lot taller than you are.
Well, I'll go slap my parents.
Yeah. Now again, there will be a lot of close-ups here because I'm not doing this for the video. I'm doing it for the job. I'm just letting you watch. But we've placed our stick under here. It's only a quarter inch thick. It's a piece of ripped out lumber that I just had lying around, 2x6 or something, I don't know. But anyway, it's the same one we used on the other side. So we're going to also put some other pieces under it for beefing up. For where the holes are going to be. So let's see, we're measuring over, see where our ropes are now. So 54 and what?
100.
54, 100 and?
145.
And 145, okay. All right, so first one was 54.
Yeah.
Okay, that's right here. We'll put the... Just got more vertical in there. Okay. 54. Hole is right here. Pen working. There we go. Oops, soda. And then 100?
100, yeah.
Pen's not working. Where's the next one?
145.
Working, but the scratch is just fine, so. Could you get me a red marker while I'm just staring at this so I don't lose it? And what we used for a drill hole last time, I forgot. I think it was 3/8. That looks like 3/8. Now you people may have to figure out your own way of getting your metal up. This is the first time I've ever used a system like this. It's a big experiment. And that's all it is. I don't know if I would recommend it, but so far it's working for me. Drill our holes. Dang it, I shot all the way through. Well, that sure held good, jeez. Why did they hold that good when I want them to? See? I do have some breaking through there. All right, let's use it up, hope it works. On that one. Oh, oh yeah, okay. The split might make it a little more difficult, but yeah, okay, it worked. All right, we're all hooked up. So,
pull these in before we
go. And, all right, we're going to scribe the back of the radius now. I get my pen working here. Okay, so we'll start down here. Too hard. All right, now I'll get up on the ladder and finish until we get to the other end, and then you can take over again. Let me just get this down here again. All right, climb on down, move your bench down to the other end. Because I'll be doing the rest now. Let's see, I think I'm going to... right-handed. Oh, my legs hurt from going up and down the ladder the other night. Yeah, this will work. And then we just keep doing this all the way around for the radius. Okay, you go stand in the middle. I'll start on time. And then screwing. So I'll untie it first. Like I said, I say this all the time, I have no idea how I went got through all that skydiving without dying from tangles. Ah! Okay. Why are you giving this up?
Because I can't do it anymore, that's why. Okay.
Got it? Get about 3 feet in, spread out as much as you can. We're going to lift it, lean it over the side, lay it down, and then we'll sort of lift and move it around without sliding it as much as we can, okay? So, grab it by the bottom now. Let it go. Okay, now lift up on it, like this. And slide it. There we go. Okay, there it is. There's our outline. Lift up on this end. There we are. All right, now I know that you guys can't see my lines, or if you can, they're very faint. So I'm actually gonna have Steve do a little something here that we never do. I'm gonna have him be cameraman for a little bit just to show you this cutter up close, this shears. So I'm gonna hand the camera to Steve and he's gonna follow me a little bit until I need him again, which will be pretty quick, but you'll get to see the action, at least of the cutters, the shears. You start recording, you say action.
Action.
Okay, and that just tells me that you're ready. Alright, that should give you an idea how that cuts. If I remember right, you saw us cutting the holes for the windows on the other side, and all we did was drill a hole in each corner there and there to get the shears into so we can cut wherever we can. This radius is a little tight, but we can get most of that done, but we won't be able to get that one done. It's just too sharp. And then on this side, we have the door right here. As you can see, we got two holes cut in the corners here where the radius starts. Little archway, you can see, and then our straight lines here, and then we have a window over here. So I'm not going to record this. As you can see, it causes me to make huge giant mistakes, and that's the reason most of my mistakes are made, is because I'm thinking about the camera. So I have suffered a lot for you people over the years just so that I could make videos for you, and I make mistakes because I'm making videos for you. So be nice to me, okay? I got an idea on how to get this up without any problems. It'd probably be a little easier. I didn't really like that method for the top sheet anyway the last time. So we'll see how this goes. Well, Steve has come up with another brilliant idea. I only hired him for his brain. Anyway, We've got clamps here in case we need them. We put these C-clamps up here, and on the inside we're protecting the wood with another piece of wood there, you can see. So we got one there. We got one up here. And we got one there. And we're gonna, and another clamp over here to grab. We're gonna hang the metal like that until we get the bottom screws in, which will position the metal where we need it. So we're not using the ropes on this one. So just another experiment, that's all. You have to understand, folks, there is no tried and true method for what we're doing here. And we don't have a factory to do it with. We're inventing things as we go along because I've never done a trailer like this before. But with my methods of teaching you how to think it out, you can restore any trailer. All you got to do is use my methods of disassembly and discovery, the reverse
engineering,
reverse engineering. See, my head's going so many different places now, I can't think at all. Anyway, if you use my methods like that, you'll be able to figure things out for yourself. So what we've done with the metal is we've stiffened it up by taping some strips to the back. See, especially in this door area. I don't know how well that's going to hold or how much help it's going to be. I figure it's better than nothing. Then we can remove all that stuff once we get it in the right area where it's hanging on the C-clips and so forth. So I'm just going to put the cameras away. I'm going to put them on the tripods and let them go because we need all our hands and I need all our brains and everything to get this done. And I can't be thinking about the cameras. All right, so here we go. There'll be a point where I'm just running around with the tape and the ladder getting things taped. So I guess we'll stand it up first. All right, here you go around there and grab it. So far, I think the sticks are helping. Just,
I got it.
Yeah, you got it, but you don't got it.
You got it, but you don't got it, but I got it.
Okay. Alright, let's lower it. Get down towards the end more. Okay. Go for it. Oh, it's easier than I thought it would be. Wow. Amazing, huh? All right, now you just stay there. That yet. We'll just leave it here. I'm trying to think of what we need to do.
If you take this clamp off, I can hold it in place.
Yeah. Okay. Not if I can let go. Okay, you hold it in place. I'm going to get the screw gun and the screw. There's the screw gun. The screws. Okay, so they're nothing but in our way. Heard about that. It's all a learning process. And then by the time you know everything, you're done. I got it. Okay. For the time being, until we can remove all the sticks. All right. Working. Now I'm going to grab another screw or two. This is working. I like this better than the other way. All right, now why don't you, let's see, I'm going to get the door one out. I don't need that. Okay. Why don't you hold on to it. Get this out of the way.
screw in. Now, I think we need a clamp up there. I mean, it's kind of warbly. Time to start taping along the top. Don't need that anymore, obviously. Let me get the ladder and just start taping the top. Hold this for me for the end. I'm gonna get all messed up. You gotta get all this out of here now. So I gotta go along and give up. Here, give me that. Good work.
We got a bow in here.
Yeah, I can't talk about that yet. To this boat up here. When we get it all flat, that should come out. Okay. That's it, don't cooperate. Take it to the hardest thing to do. Can't put any tape on until we get that stick out. So that's the first problem of the city. And that's the thing, there's a lot of things you can't foresee. So you have to deal with them. Think on your feet. Are really doing right now is kind of safety. They're not really holding a lot. gone now?
Yep. Yeah, it looks great.
Yeah, it worked. And now I gotta get screws and something in both ends here. And I'm not sure. And we're just gonna have to do a screw 2.5 inches in, or 5 inches in, 2.5 will go. So those things are every 2.5 inches. One more piece of tape on it. Okay, this is glazing tape. You can get this at vintagetrailergaskets.com, and it's for putting glass in, but it works really good for sealing when you don't sealing the seam when you have no S-lock or seam lock. So what we're going to do is we're going to do like one screw, and I'll put it all the way across, and we'll put the screw back in, and then I'll do it the rest of the way down the trailer. So you can watch, oh geez, like my big feet just keep hitting the tripod. So you can watch me do this one, and then I'm going to be doing it the rest of the way down the trailer. All right. Come on over here, Steve. I'm going to have you hold this end. All you got to do is just hold that end up and then take the screw out. Lay it right here. And you don't want it to move. You want to keep it in the same place because it's going to stick there permanently with the tape. The tape will make it stick there permanently. So you got scissors. One of the things that people used to like about Bill and hate about me was when he had nothing to do but stand there and hold something, I would say, he'd say, what do you want me to do? I go, stand there and look stupid. It's just a joke. Stand there and look stupid. So he would start making faces in the camera, because the camera's pointed right at him. And while I'm trying to do something, and he would make all these funny, stupid looking faces, and they loved that about him. He could be a star. Every time, you know, he comes back for some reason, everybody goes, oh, Bill's back! Bill Roy's back. They named him Bill Roy. They named him. My viewers named him Bill Roy. I didn't make that long enough, damn it. Another little piece. It's okay. Thought it was long enough. See, so we leave the tape on the back while we do this. The siding for the tape, we leave that on there while we do this. We get it all in place. All right, now let's make sure this is in the right place. It's going to be permanent here in a minute. Wow. The buckles. All looks like it's in the right place. Okay, here we go. Pull it out a little bit. Get it started. It's 2 inches short. You do this just like putty tape. You pull it back at a 180 degree angle. You don't need to do this. Start in the middle, look towards the edges. There you go. And on the bottom is basically in. All you gotta do is install the nails. But that's gonna hold, you believe me. That is strong stuff. That's gonna hold. We can't pull it away now. I mean, we could if we had to, but.
Do you even need the screw?
I'm going to put the screw in just for kicks. But no, we don't. All right. Now we're going to go to the other end.
But you know what I think I'll do first? I think I'll put about a foot of it here where the door is first. Sound like a good idea?
Yeah.
What I'm talking about, folks, is right here. Because this is a long span. So I'm going to put some right there just to get it started with holding power. And then I'll continue it from the other end. But this will make for good holding power. So I'm going to put this piece up under here. This time I'll go all the way to the end. Okay. I'll pull the tape off. There we go. That'll hold it there for a bit. And now we'll go ahead and do the rest of it. So I'll let you watch from this angle. Put the screw on. The tape back on. Didn't have to always learn things the hard way. But see, that's what I do so that you don't have to. Huh, it didn't stick as hard as I thought it would. Alright, well then hell with it. That came right off. It has holding power, just not pulling out away from it. It doesn't have any holding power that way. Well then I learned something else. Well, that's cool, you know. Great. Alright, now I'm going to pull the tape. So there's what we've done all the way down there, and so now we're just going to close it off and fold it, you know, press it in there, and then I'll be ready for nails. Now we start in the middle. You keep everything else away, keep the end away. You start in the middle and work out. If you don't, you'll end up with a buckle. There we go. You can end up with a buckle, let's put it that way. Alright, it's on. The metal's on. Let me get this other screw back in. Safety purposes. Alright, there it is. It's up.
That was easy.
Actually, it wasn't too bad. But having to learn on the go, on the fly, is, you know, it's kind of like when your dad says sink or swim and he throws you in the pool. That's kind of what we had to do with this, is we had to basically figure all this out as we go, because I've never done it before. So I go through all this pain and heartache so you don't have to. That's because I'm mobile tech. Next thing we got to do is snap lines for our grid for our nails, just like we did down here. And that should be it. We should be good. I'm going to put another piece of tape here and there because I don't trust it. Now that I know we have tape left. I want to do that in a couple places, just because I don't trust it. And that's because we have a swamp cooler going, for one thing. Tends to want to loosen tape up. Make that one really long there. That pretty much ought to do it, I think. We got clamps in place to help hold it. And yeah, that should do it. And then the glue, the sticky tape. Is that right in front of you there? Can't see anything? Alrighty, we're gonna snap lines now. You've seen us do that. Okay, you got the chalk line?
Yeah.
Ooh. All right, let's go between the door and the window first. That's right here. See that? There?
Yep.
I'm gonna fix for that one. One more to go, and then we can do the uprights. They're all pretty easy to see, too. We do have one right up here somewhere. So that's going to be this line. We have them on this line. We have them on this line. And then we don't have any more until we get to over here, and this one is up here on this line. Okay? So that's it. On the bottom, like I said, there's two here. Yeah, there's two here and two here.
Yeah, there's actually a mark.
There's a single one just up above the corner of the window somewhere. It lines up with that line. You don't have to go all the way down there.
I didn't want it to hit the...
No, you can hold it right here. See?
Okay.
You're not going all the way down anymore. Just hold it right there on that line. There you go, just like that. Okay. I'll stay right here. Same thing, just hold it on the line. Back up some of these.
Okay.
And then there's no more until that one over there. Installing nails tomorrow. Cool. Nice.
start prepping the roof for roof work. So it's probably going to take me,
well, let me finish the camera stuff here.